This is California Girls.
Where I started putting things on
your boobs.
My bra. Oh my God, it was like
you were doing the choir.
Oh, oh my God, it's in
you
my
body. You got it!
It's in my body.
My sweet potatoes, I'm Mo Hart, and get ready because Amazon Music's The Walk-In is back. We're walking you into the closets of the biggest names in music. And we're walking out with the stories behind their most iconic looks. It's The Walk-In, honey.
Legendary children, I'm Mo Hart, and The Walk-In is back. Season 3 is kicking off in Vegas. It's gonna be big, baby. Big. Now, when I went to bed last night, I did not know that I was gonna be waking up in Vegas. But I'm here in Sin City, in the entertainment capital, bringing you what? A music and fashion icon, the
Miss Katy Perry!
Katy Perry is an unstoppable force. She is one of the top selling and most popular music artists of all time. You can add actress, TV personality, designer, and fashion trailblazer to her long list of accomplishments. And now with her own Vegas residency, this California girl has proven it's her world and she wants us to have fun in it.
Oh my gosh, I can't wait. I'm so nervous. I get to go meet the doll. Miss Katy Perry.
You know, I'm a doll too. We're gonna do doll things.
Hi. Oh, this is Katy!
She's real sparkly.
I'm coming.
Oh my goddess. I thought I was gonna be too much. I think she's the most.
Okay, this is really not like in the movie. This is long. Oh. Stop it all! Stop everything, yo! Embarrassed. I ripped a hole in my clutch. And I can't meet Katy Perry like this girl! This will work. It's giving a little, you know, rhinestone, a little Bob Mackie-ish. Carry on! Do you know how long I have waited for this moment?
Oh my gosh. Wait, you have extra numbers?
Well, I mean, you're not the only star, Mandy.
Hi.
Oh my gosh. Can you give me a full turn? Yes. Can I borrow that for after the show?
Yeah.
I'm trying to take it to the club.
Let me get this out.
Okay.
I remember coming out 2011. Hearing Teenage Dream like on the radio and driving down the street. For me, you, I don't get like this, Katy, so I'm not trying to like gash.
I watched all of them. I haven't seen you do this on any of them.
I remember the backlash that you got like leaving Christian ministry, all of that stuff.
You know all about it.
Right. And so the same time they were giving it to you, I was kind of experiencing it at the same time. So I just meshed with your resilience.
Where are you
and determination.
From?
I'm from New York, but I lived in Kansas City, Missouri. I was in full-time ministry.
You were in ministry?
Trying to pray the gateway, girl. It didn't work.
They tried to do that to me, too.
Really?
Oh, yeah. My mom's still praying.
Mom is too.
Hi, Mom. In the name of the Lord.
Oh, my God. Check out your closet.
Yes, because that's what we're here for.
Yeah, uh-huh, and you have a few things that look like they might stretch.
Yeah, there's some four-way stretch in there.
Oh my gosh, Katy Perry, we are here in your closet.
That's right, we're going in.
So, can we start all the way at the beginning?
Yes, they say the devil's in the details, but you know, since we come from the church, we like to say, God is in the details. And there are so many details in here. I'm sorry.
Let's start right here at the throwback.
Okay. This is Johnny Wujek, who I've done a lot of costumes with, even up until Play, the show that we're at.
Big Muscle Johnny.
Hot Johnny.
Hot Johnny.
Yeah, Hot Johnny.
Hi, Johnny.
Hi.
I think, if my memory serves me correctly, this is California Girl.
This is California Girls, where I started putting things on
your boobs.
My bra. Oh my God, it's in
you
my body.
You got it!
It's in my body. I can't believe they've actually stayed intact.
Yeah.
And these are rhinestoned. They are actually like diesel shorts. D Diesel's still Diesel,
yeah.
But it was when Diesel was Diesel.
Diesel. Yeah.
There's like a funny little story about California Girls, the music video. You're supposed to get a fake tan the night before and then wash it off in the morning. I got one the day of, like the morning I was filming the music video. Mm-hmm. I got gradually tanner as the day went on. So they had to color correct the whole music video because I was like pasty, pasty. And then I was like,
Orangelo.
I was Orangina.
Orangina.
I was crazy. But I was wearing this outfit. And if you take like a free shot of me in this outfit, you'll see how tan I was.
I live. I'm just very surprised at like how much was up here on the girls.
This was a heavy moment. Okay, check this out.
Now this, my dear.
This was from the California Dreams tour.
Yes.
But actually, it's electronic. Look.
I'm so terrified. I'm like, oh God.
She's over 10 years old.
Wow, she still look good, girl.
She still look good. This tit no longer spins.
Okay, well, as long as you got one good working tit, you can still pay the rent.
Got one.
Maybe
one.
An electric bill, maybe not the full.
Next.
Now, who made this? Now, I say that this is Jeremy Scott.
This is Jeremy Scott.
But this doesn't say Moschino. So please let me know the
difference. No, it's Jeremy Scott. I think it's actually pre-Moschino.
Ah.
Or maybe during that time. I played the Super Bowl in 2015. I chose Missy Elliott myself.
Lovely.
And Lenny Kravitz. And I wanted to have them on the stage and share the stage with them. But this is Jeremy Scott. It's my entrance outfit, actually.
Mm-hmm. Does it stretch?
It's vinyl. Vinyl doesn't stretch much.
Okay.
There were so many different outfits under here.
Yeah, because that's what I was going to say. Like, how do you do a quick change?
For Super Bowl, the camera had to go on something else and then whip back to me. And all of a sudden, I was like, we rehearsed it so many times. One of my show directors literally had a cattle prod and would come chasing me to do it again. And it's like, no. Because I had to like get back on the lion and do the whole thing. And it was 12, 13 minutes of jam-packed, just being so physical, dancing, costume changes. I actually slide down a pole and one of my outfits was made of latex. My beach ball balloon outfit.
Yes.
That was actually underneath this.
So you were dying.
Well, I was sweating already. I slid down the pole, but it burned off my whole outfit.
Oh.
My whole crotch came undone, and I was like,
That part.
I can't do this, so I changed it right before the show.
Curtis, we call that a fire puss.
Yeah.
This is Versace.
It's real, and she's real crystallized. I wore this to the VMAs. I asked Riff Raff to come with me, and we both wore matching Versace that actually pays homage to Justin and Britney. They custom made this for me, and that moment that Britney gave us,
it
was the moment, and I wanted to pay my respects. Can I just say one thing?
Yes.
I have spent so much time thinking I was fat, wasting time thinking I was fat years ago. I mean, like, the thing is, I was never fat.
Never.
Girls. You are not fat.
I look fat.
Are those pictures?
Videos of me on Drag Race, and I was like, I remember feeling huge.
Yeah.
And then I watch it, and I'm like, I was smaller then than I am now.
That's crazy. You waste so much energy. Don't waste the time. Use that mental power for manifesting.
Okay, my dear, so tell me about this Carmen Miranda look.
Like, yes, it was inspired by Carmen Miranda.
Oh, I was right.
Yeah, it's like fruit on the head, but fruit on the body. I haven't seen this for years.
Aww.
And it was my first performance on the Grammys, and right as I was making it, and everything was happening, singing I Kissed a Girl, my parents were deeply ashamed. And I was on
Living
my way
the dream.
Up.
That part, baby, I was on my way up.
My whole theme for my first album was fruit. And I actually have a fruit tattoo. Where is she? Oh yeah, strawberry.
Damn. Strawberry.
A strawberry, that's actually what we call it.
I noticed, I was like, wait a minute. She said, take the B out and put a P.
That's right. The Blondes made this. You know the Blondes.
Yes.
And this thing is intact, too.
She really is. Girl,
y'all kept
her in the vault.
She's a vault. I mean, we have a professional warehouse where we like have everything hung in garment bags and whole bits.
This is giving me the fruit that your grandmother has as decoration.
Yeah.
Like if she's like 70 something. Tell us, what was your first like big purchase after you blew up and became?
A Marc Jacobs purse.
Ooh.
Yeah. I think I still have it somewhere in storage. Everyone had it at the time. I was always on a budget. $20, going to the thrift store, going to the vintage stores.
Yes.
Cultivating my style, you know.
You have moved through the decades and eras of fashion, but I feel like you always have this classic, to me, 50s, like, vibe. How did you kind of...
Yeah, the pinup vibe really.
Very.
At age 13, I decided that was gonna be my look. It was like gonna be like this cute Betty Page, girls from the 40s and 50s. And I learned actually how to swing dance, like 50s dance.
Oh.
So I was a part of like every Tuesday night, I would go and swing dance at this club at the rec center.
Where are you from again?
Santa Barbara, California.
Oh, okay, safe.
Yeah,
okay,
safe. Good. You know, you could always find like a piece from the 40s at the thrift store. With
yeah,
like,
it's so
buttons.
True, yes.
And it evolves, and my fashion style on stage is really heightened, you know?
For sure.
I mean, I look like a mushroom. I got my own Katy Perry collection shoes, mushroom heels, since I have a shoe line.
Yeah!
Actually, they're available on Amazon. So you guys can get these and so many more on Amazon. They stop traffic and start conversation.
Oh.
When I'm off stage, it's a bit more neutral. Like, for instance, I don't really have Swarovskis or glitter at my house. Nothing, no, because like in my professional life, it's so much.
Yeah.
So I have to retreat a little bit and like, you know, catch my breath to go step back into that glitter bomb.
Very, very true, that's how I feel. I just walk in my house constantly sweeping and I'm like, more rhinestones and glitter again.
I know, I know.
Hateful.
I go outside to open those.
Can you imagine? Oh, gotta do a little glitter lid for the outside. Tell us, what's the inspiration for the mushroom and this new vibe? Like, how did you get there?
There's a moment in Play, which is my show in Vegas. It's a little Alice in Wonderland falling down the rabbit hole.
So you ate some mushrooms on vacation and you got inspired. Lovely, boom.
Boom.
For me, this screams, you know, when you're playing Mario and
did
you
it,
hit
did
the,
did
yeah,
did
and the little mushroom comes out.
Yeah.
Very that. Well, let's blast into the
future.
Spin, 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 spin. Oh, we're here. Hey girl, how you doing? Tell us about this.
This is what I wore performing at Glastonbury, which is a huge festival in the UK. I felt really a part of the cool club when I got invited.
Okay.
This was for Witness, my record Witness. But you know what? I've got so many costumes to show you today.
I just want to let y'all know, I sent this one to my manager and I said, tell her to bring this one, because
that's for like my showgirl moment.
Ah.
My aunt was a top showgirl in Vegas, actually.
Ah, and so this is a full circle moment.
Oh, there's so much to being in Vegas. My family has a lot of ties here. I mean, I knew I wanted a residency, but I didn't know where I was gonna end up. So my aunt was a top showgirl. My grandma was a seamstress for that show. They actually worked at the Stardust Hotel. And this hotel, Resorts World, is built on top of the Stardust Hotel.
Goosebumps, like.
I was like,
Holy Spirit, I'm supposed to be here.
Whoever is playing me in this simulation game, you're doing a great job.
All right, my dear, this is heavy.
I only wear it for a little bit. It's the opening number, and I actually have this pink one underneath it.
You just believe in sweating.
I am sweating out the toxins every single show.
I live.
I'm like, I will never drink again.
Yes. How do you stay on stage and your makeup doesn't run?
You and I both know you're only as good as your glam.
Factual!
Okay, so when you have the glam team, when you have the right tinctures and ointments and powders, then you know you won't sweat through.
Facts. You'll just be shiny.
You should see backstage when I'm changing into these clothes, I can change in like less than 2 minutes. I'm holding onto a rail and like Michael Anthony, my makeup artist, is like patting my face. And Rick Henry is doing my hair and I'm getting dressed by my wardrobe team. I'm just like holding on for dear life. They're zipping me up and blah, blah, blah. And it's under 2 minutes. Now, I will never do that at home. So Orlando Bloom, don't expect me to do a turnaround like that. It's never gonna happen.
Can we side note just say that, girl, you got the one that everybody wanted?
Okay, well.
I said, wait a minute, let's get it, baby!
Honey, I had to go through a lot of valleys before I found that peak.
Praise God. Who made these, do we know?
Zaldi. Zaldi, the Gaudi.
RuPaul's designer.
That's right. He made this one and this one. And we went through a lot of iterations on this one because I literally wanted it to be like an umbrella.
Yeah.
Because I want it to look like a doll because I play a doll in the show.
Yes. This is truly giving.
Giving.
Ooh, what is
this? Here we go. This is a Swarovski'd crystallized towel. It's like
so
a
does
very
this go
fitted.
With this?
Yes, this headpiece. Here she is.
Very. I live.
Yeah.
Now everybody's gonna be at home bedazzling their towels so they can go sing your songs and look fabulous.
Remember when Rita Ora wore that whole towel number on the red carpet?
Yeah.
I was inspired. Thanks, Rita, love you.
Thanks, Rita. Okay, now I remember that this is the one where the frog was like slightly kissing you, humping you in the photo.
Yeah, doing it froggy style. These are chaps. This is also Zaldi, a Zaldi moment. And yeah, my butt kind of hangs out a little bit. We're giving cutouts. Oh, and I wear the hat.
Ah!
Where the mushroom hat.
Oh, it's fabulous. So cute.
It is super fun.
Do you pin or do you have an elastic band?
I have an elastic band here, Velcro.
Okay.
And lots of padding.
Look at the detail on the inside. Oh, they really made it look like a mushroom.
They sure did. Look at all these little cuts. Again, she's heavy, right?
I live.
Look at this. This one is also Zaldi. We love Zaldi.
What is...
You know, this is where we started.
Oh, okay, okay, okay.
A cupcake, a little foam. And then this is where we're at now.
Oh, the budget is increased, girl.
These are hard, like aluminum. Yeah, actually, and you know what's so interesting about this one? It has like a workable feature. Like if you're thirsty on stage and you need a drink, it's very easy. You just do it. Tap, 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 a little pour.
I want one. I need one immediately. That would be everything on stage. Girl, you could do your number, talk to the crowd.
I'm thirsty.
Woo, this is so good. Sir, can I borrow your cup, fill it up, boom, and then go back. You said I want fashion, but I need a boost of energy. The girl is giving. Okay, now this one, just tell us who made it so I can go get one.
Disco Dance. Obviously, everything is Bob Mackie inspired.
For sure, for sure.
And actually, this had to be cut and everything. This had a long fishtail. We had to cut. We had to like make it a little cut out. And this is also a shape that's inspired by Cher.
Yes, it is very much like hers. This is so, the way
it
sparkles.
And this looks invisible. This is like a whole cutout situation. It looks amazing.
When nude mesh actually matches your skin and it goes invisible.
That's
for you pro tip girls.
Okay. Pro tip, but I have gotten too tan in the past.
Oh, so you look a little beige.
I look a little beige here.
I love you so much. This has been so amazing just getting to go through your closet, getting to like talk to you. Like, here you go. I was a fan before, but I'm like a super fan now because you are just real.
You know what they call those?
What?
Katy Cats. She's a Katy Cat. Katy Cat, she is. But yeah, thank you. I appreciate you too because you know what? You can always look this fake when you are so real. You know what I'm saying?
Say it again for the wide camera in the middle.
You can always look this fake when you are so real and it looks good.
Boom. We'll see you next time on The Walk-In. Stream live on Amazon Music. Bye! I'll catch you.
Girl,
she tried to do a dip.
I just learned how to do the death drop, but I wasn't about to split my pants again. I was going to.
She was doing drag brunch. Fall out. Point the toe. Yeah!
I just learned you can tell. Help me, God.
Thank you so much for watching. Click here to subscribe and click here to watch more episodes of The Walk-In.
And I think you have to click here to follow me on Amazon Music.
Yes.
Right here.
Thank you so much for watching Amazon Music. We'll see you next time. Come on, girl, let's get a snack.